Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to explain quite a few topics that most folks just don't understand, such as what is a marginal tax rate? What is an effective tax rate? What's the difference between the two? What does it even mean to be in a 24% tax bracket? How much taxes am I actually paying if I'm in a 24% tax bracket? All these topics and more coming up in this video. All right, so let's jump right into the video. If you don't know, my name is Navi Miraj. I'm a certified public accountant helping real estate professionals and small business owners save thousands of dollars in taxes. But today's video is for everyone, whether they're a small business owner or not. And I'd like to explain this by way of an example because I think that's the best way to learn. And so in this example, this individual earned $117,400. Now, as I said, that could be because they worked for an employer, or maybe they ran a small business, and after deducting their expenses, this is what they arrived at. Included in this number could be things like dividend income and interest income and so on. And so from that number, we're going to deduct adjustments. Adjustments are a handful of items that come off the gross income number. And in this example, I'm using something that you might be familiar with, the traditional IRA. So a traditional IRA contribution is an adjustment, and that reduces the 117 by $5,000, and we arrive at $112,400 for this individual's adjusted gross income, right? That term sometimes confuses people. All adjusted gross income is their gross income minus these handful of adjustments that they may be allowed to take. And so now that we're at AGI of $112,400, you now have the decision to take the standard deduction, or you can itemize your deductions. Now, with the Tax Cuts and Jobs Act, you know, the standard deduction was increased quite a bit. So it's difficult for most Americans to get itemized deductions above and over this amount. So if your itemized deductions are less than this amount, then you'll take the standard deduction, which is this example, that's what this taxpayer did. Now, we're at taxable income. So we had gross income, deducted adjustments, arrived at AGI, minus the standard deduction, arriving at $100,000 of taxable income. Now, in our system, tax system here in America, not every dollar is taxed the same. And so the tax brackets now come into play. And so this individual happens to be a single individual. And so of their $100,000 that they earned, or that's taxable rather, the first $9,875 is taxed at 10%. So in this example, it's taxed at $987. And it goes on and on and on. And so, for example, of the $100,000, $40,126 through $85,525 were taxed at a 22% tax rate. And because this person sort of maxed out, if you will, at $100,000, their last set of tax dollars fall within this bracket here, between 85 and 163.3. So on that sum of money, the 85,526 through to the 100,000, they paid $3,474 in taxes. And so there's a big misconception out there that because I'm in a 24% tax bracket, that must mean that 24% times my taxable income is equal to the taxes I paid. But that's not. You'd be incorrect if you assume that. The taxes that you paid are the total of these amounts here. So in this example, it's $18,079. Now, another question I get is, what is a marginal tax rate? Marginal tax rate just means, what is the last dollar, or rather, what's the last taxable income dollar, what rate was it taxed at? So in this example, if this individual had another dollar worth of income here, taxable income that is, they would pay 24% tax on that dollar, or 24 cents in this example. And so, you know, the marginal tax rate, again, is a rate at which the last dollar you earned is taxed at. Now, what is an effective tax rate? There's a few different ways that professionals like to calculate this, but the most common way that you'll probably see if you use software such as TurboTax, for example, it would be your total taxes paid divided by your adjusted gross income. And in this example, your effective tax rate is 16.1%. That was the $18,079 divided by the 112.4. So their effective tax rate, the amount of money they paid against this AGI amount, was 16.1%. So in this video, hopefully you learn, you know, what is adjusted gross income? What is the marginal tax rate? What is the effective tax rate? And how the whole tax bracket kind of system works. If you found this video insightful, or if you have a question, please comment below, like, and subscribe, and I'll see you in another video. Thanks.